Hi, good morning. In this video, discuss about the bacterial cell structure. Already previous classes we are discussed in bacterial types and bacterial introduction. In this video, talking about bacterial structure, their parts and their functions. Bacteria is a prokaryotic organism. Prokaryotic means there is no membrane around the nucleus. So the naked DNA, visible the DNA. So there is no membrane bound around the nucleus is called the prokaryotic organism. In bacterial cells have bacterial cells enveloped by three layers. The outermost layer is the glycocalyx, and the middle layer is the cell wall, and the innermost layer is the plasma membrane or cell membrane. These are the three layers are cover the bacterial cell. The outermost layer, first we will say the glycocalyx. Glycocalyx is the outermost layer of the bacterial cell. It is external to the cell wall. So the function of the glycocalyx is the production of a cell wall. These glycocalyx is again made up of two layers. One is the capsule. Capsule, and next one is the slime layer. The capsule is the thick layer. It is covered by gelatinous sheath. The capsule function is the protection of the cell wall. The capsule is made up of like a polysaccharides and D-glutamic acid. It is important for the MCET students. Glutamic acid. Some bacteria produce capsules. Some bacteria do not produce any capsules. These capsulated bacteria produce smooth colonies. Become virulent. Virulent means it released poisons or toxins causing pneumonia disease in rats. So virulent means harmful. It means it released poisons or toxins. This type of bacteria is called the S-type bacteria. So S-type bacteria is a capsulated bacteria and virulent. And next one is some bacteria do not produce any capsules. So non-capsulated bacteria produce rough colonies and non-virulent. This type of bacteria is called the R-type bacteria. So R-type bacteria is non-virulent. And S-type bacteria is become virulent. So it released toxins. It not released any toxins. And next one is the slime layer. Slime layer is the thin layer. It is also protect the cell wall. The slime layer also made up of polysaccharides like dextrin and dextran. And next one is the middle layer is the cell wall. It is external to the plasma membrane. And below the capsule is called the cell wall. In bacterial cells have rigid cell wall. That's why they can easily survive in all atmospheric condition. So the bacterial cell wall is made up of peptidoglycan and murine. It is very important for MCET students and other exams. Bacterial cell wall is made up of peptidoglycan and murine. That's why they can easily survive in all atmospheric condition. And the bacterial cell wall component is the magnesium, Mg2+. Magnesium is the bacterial cell wall presence of magnesium and combined to the tycoic acid. टाइकोइक एसिड. बैक्टीरियल सेल वॉल एलिमेंट इज द मैग्नीशियम, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर एमसेट स्टूडेंट. मैग्नीशियम इट कंबाइंड विद द टाइकोइक एसिड. ऑन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ टाइकोइक एसिड और एब्सेंस ऑफ टाइकोइक एसिड द बैक्टीरियल सेल्स इज अगेन क्लासिफाइड इंटू टू टाइप्स, ग्राम पॉजिटिव बैक्टीरिया, ग्राम पॉजिटिव बैक्टीरिया एंड ग्राम नेगेटिव बैक्टीरिया. सो दीज ग्राम स्टेनिंग टेक्निक इज डिस्कस्ड इन अनदर वीडियो. एंड नेक्स्ट वन इज द थर्ड वन, इनर मोस्ट लेयर इज द प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन. इनर मोस्ट लेयर इज प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन और सेल मेम्ब्रेन. दिस प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन एक्ट एज ए सेमी परमेबल मेम्ब्रेन. प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन एक्ट एज ए सेमी permeable membrane. Why it is called semi-permeable membrane? In this plasma membrane have small pores on their surface. So this plasma membrane allow only particular liquid like structures only through the membrane. So it only allow the liquid like structures through their membrane. So it is called a selectively semi-permeable membrane. And this plasma membrane or a cell membrane and protect the internal organelles also. And in bacterial cells have liquid like structure in the inner. It is called the cytoplasm. In this have liquid like structures is called the cytoplasm. Cytoplasm. In this cytoplasm, presence of 80% of water. 80% of water along with some enzymes and ribosomes and some carbohydrates and inorganic substances. Cytoplasm is a liquid like structure. It is present in the innermost layer of the plasma membrane. In this cytoplasm, presence of 80% of water along with some enzymes, ribosomes and carbohydrates and inorganic substance. In this cytoplasm, presence of all cell organelles, but it is a prokaryotic organism. Bacteria is a prokaryotic organism. That's why they do not have any membrane bound cell organelles in prokaryotic organism. In this prokaryotic organism, presence of only ribosomes and nucleoid only. Remain all cell organelles are absent. In eukaryotic organism, presence of all cell organelles. So that is the difference between the prokaryotic and eukaryotic organism. And next, another important organelle is the ribosomes. These ribosomes are the very smaller and without membrane organelle. So that is freely in the cytoplasm, smaller organelle ribosomes. These ribosomes are main sites of the protein synthesis. Ribosomes are main sites of protein synthesis. It is very important for MCET students and other exams. Ribosomes is the main function is the protein synthesis. In prokaryotic organism, presence of 70S ribosomes. S means Swedberg units. One of the scientist name. S means Swedberg units. These 70S units is again classified into subunits. 50S and 30S. They appear like this. One larger unit, one smaller unit. One larger unit, one smaller unit. Larger unit is 50S. Smaller unit is 30S. So that is here another organelle is the nucleoid or cell membrane. Another organelle is the nucleoid or cell membrane. In bacterial cells have another organelle nucleoid or DNA. In bacterial cells have two types of chromosomes or genetic material. One of the main genetic material and extra genetic material plasmid. Main genetic material and extra genetic material. The main genetic material is called genophore. Bacterial chromosomes. Bacterial main chromosomes or genetic material is called the genophore. That is the న్యూక్లియాయిడ్ ఆరు డిఎన్ఏ. దీస్ న్యూక్లియాయిడ్ స్ట్రక్చర్ ఈజ్ ఓన్లీ అపియర్ ఇన్ ద ప్రోకారియోటిక్ ఆర్గనిజమ్స్. న్యూక్లియాయిడ్ మీన్స్ నాక్డ్ విజిబుల్ జెనెటిక్ మెటీరియల్ బట్ వితౌట్ న్యూక్లియర్ మెంబ్రెయిన్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ ద న్యూక్లియాయిడ్. దీస్ న్యూక్లియాయిడ్ స్ట్రక్చర్ ఈజ్ ఓన్లీ అపియర్ ఇన్ ద ప్రోకారియోటిక్ ఆర్గనిజమ్స్ ఓన్లీ. సో ద బ్యాక్టీరియల్ మెయిన్ జెనెటిక్ మెటీరియల్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ జీనోఫోర్ ఆర్ బ్యాక్టీరియల్ క్రోమోజోమ్స్ ఆర్ న్యూక్లియాయిడ్. ఇన్ దిస్ బ్యాక్టీరియల్ సెల్స్ హ్యావ్ ఎక్స్ట్రా క్రోమోజోమల్ జెనెటిక్ మెటీరియల్. ఎక్స్ట్రా క్రోమోజోమల్ జెనెటిక్ మెటీరియల్ ఆర్ ఎడిషనల్ జెనెటిక్ మెటీరియల్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ ద ప్లాస్మిడ్. ఎక్స్ట్రా క్రోమోజోమల్ జెనెటిక్ మెటీరియల్ ఆర్ ఎడిషనల్ క్రోమోజోమల్ జెనెటిక్ మెటీరియల్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ ద ప్లాస్మిడ్. వాట్ ఈస్ ద యూజ్ ఆఫ్ ప్లాస్మిడ్? ప్లాస్మిడ్ ఈజ్ ఎపియర్ లైక్ ఏ సర్క్యులర్ రౌండ్ అండ్ డబుల్ స్టాండర్డ్ డిఎన్ఏ. ఇట్ కంపోజ్డ్ ఆఫ్ డబుల్ స్టాండర్డ్ డిఎన్ఏ, సర్క్యులర్ అండ్ రౌండ్ షేప్డ్. ఇటు రెసిస్టెన్స్ టు డ్రగ్స్ అండ్ సమ్ యాంటీబయాటిక్స్. అండ్ ఇట్ ఈజ్ ఇండివిజువల్లీ సెల్ఫ్ రెప్లికేటింగ్ క్యాపబుల్. ప్రొడ్యూస్ డాటస్ సెల్ఫ్ రెప్లికేటింగ్. ద టర్మ్ ప్లాస్మిడ్ వాజ్ కాయిన్డ్ బై లెడర్బర్గ్. ఇన్ 1952. ప్లాస్మిడ్ ఈజ్ నౌడేస్ యూజ్డ్ ఇన్ ప్లాస్మిడ్స్ ఇన్ జెనెటిక్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ ప్రాసెస్ ఆల్సో. దట్స్ వై దే ఆర్ మోస్ట్లీ ఎక్స్పెరిమెంట్స్ ఆర్ యూజింగ్ ఇన్ బ్యాక్టీరియాస్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ ప్రెజెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్లాస్మిడ్. అండ్ నెక్స్ట్ వన్, హియర్ హ్యావ్ లాంగ్ హెయిర్ లైక్ స్ట్రక్చర్స్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ ద పిలీ. లాంగ్ హెయిర్ లైక్ స్ట్రక్చర్స్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ పిలీ. ద పిలీ ఈజ్ నాట్ యూజ్డ్ ఫర్ ఏ లోకోమోషన్. ఇట్ ఈజ్ యూజ్డ్ ఫర్ ద డ్యూరింగ్ కాంజుగేషన్ టైమ్. కాంజుగేషన్ మీన్స్ బ్యాక్టీరియల్ రీప్రొడక్షన్ మెథడ్ ఈజ్ కాంజుగేషన్. కాంజుగేషన్ ద ట్రాన్స్ఫర్ ఆఫ్ జెనెటిక్ మెటీరియల్ ఫ్రమ్ వన్ బ్యాక్టీరియం సెల్ టు అనదర్ బ్యాక్టీరియం సెల్ త్రూ ద కాంజుగేషన్ ట్యూబ్స్. సో ద పిలీ ఈజ్ యూజ్డ్ ఫర్ ఫార్మేషన్ ఆఫ్ కాంజుగేషన్ ట్యూబ్స్. డ్యూరింగ్ కాంజుగేషన్ టైమ్. సో ద పిలీ ఈజ్ మేడప్ ఆఫ్ ఏ స్పెషల్ ప్రోటీన్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ పిలీన్. వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఫర్ ఎంసెట్ స్టూడెంట్స్. ద పిలీ ఈజ్ మేడప్ ఆఫ్ ఏ స్పెషల్ ప్రోటీన్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ పిలీన్. దీస్ పిలీ ఆర్ యూజ్డ్ ఫర్ ద కాంజుగేషన్ టైమ్ ఫార్మేషన్ ఆఫ్ కాంజుగేషన్ ట్యూబ్స్. అండ్ హియర్ హ్యావ్ ఎనదర్ ఆర్గనల్ ఈజ్ ద హియర్ హ్యావ్ లాంగ్ థ్రెడ్ లైక్ స్ట్రక్చర్స్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ ద ప్లాజిల్లమ్. లాంగ్ థ్రెడ్ లైక్ స్ట్రక్చర్స్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ ద ప్లాజిల్లమ్. ప్లాజిల్లమ్ ఈజ్ యూజ్డ్ ఫర్ ద మూమెంట్ ఆర్ లోకోమోషన్. ప్లాజిల్లమ్ ఈజ్ యూజ్డ్ ఫర్ ద మూమెంట్ ఆర్ లోకోమోషన్. సో ఇన్ దిస్ ప్లాజిల్లమ్ హ్యావ్ త్రీ పార్ట్స్, హుక్ పార్ట్, బేసల్ బాడీ అండ్ ఫిలమెంట్. పొజిషన్ అండ్ దేర్ నెంబర్. ఆన్ ద బేసిస్ ఆఫ్ పొజిషన్ అండ్ దేర్ నెంబర్ ద ప్లాజిల్లా ఈజ్ అగైన్ క్లాసిఫైడ్ ఇన్ టు సబ్ టైప్స్. దీస్ ప్లాజిల్లా సబ్ టైప్స్ ఆర్ ఆల్రెడీ డిస్కస్డ్ ఇన్ ప్రీవియస్ వీడియో. అండ్ నెక్స్ట్ వన్ ఈజ్ ద హియర్ హ్యావింగ్ ఇన్ఫోల్డింగ్స్ ఆఫ్ ద ప్లాస్మా మెమ్రిన్. ఇన్ఫోల్డింగ్స్ ఆఫ్ ద ప్లాస్మా మెమ్రిన్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ మీసోజోమ్స్. దీస్ మీసోజోమ్స్ ఆర్ యూజ్డ్ ఫర్ ద సెల్ డివిజన్ టైమ్. దీస్ మీసోజోమ్స్ ఆర్ యూజ్డ్ ఫర్ ఇన్ సెల్ డివిజన్ టైమ్ ఫార్మేషన్ ఆఫ్ క్రాస్ వాల్. సెల్ డివిజన్ మీన్స్ ద బ్యాక్టీరియల్ సెల్ డివైడెడ్ ఇన్ టు డాటర్ సెల్ ఇన్ దిస్ డివిజన్ ద ఫార్మేషన్ ఆఫ్ క్రాస్ వాల్. సో దిస్ వాల్ ఫార్మేషన్ యూజ్డ్ ఫర్ ద మీసోజోమ్స్. దీస్ మీసోజోమ్స్ ఆర్ యూజ్డ్ ఫర్ ద రెస్పిరేషన్ ఆల్సో. సెల్ రెస్పిరేషన్ ఆల్సో అండ్ డిఎన్ఏ రెప్లికేషన్. ఇట్ ఈజ్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఫర్ ఎంసెట్ ఎగ్జామ్స్. మీసోజోమ్స్ ఫంక్షన్ ఈజ్ ద యూజ్డ్ ఫర్ ఫార్మేషన్ ఆఫ్ క్రాస్ వాల్ అండ్ రెస్పిరేషన్ అండ్ డిఎన్ఏ రెప్లికేషన్. ఇట్ ఈజ్ ఆరిజినేట్ ఫ్రమ్ ద ప్లాస్మా మెమ్రిన్. ఇన్ఫోల్డింగ్స్ ఆఫ్ ద ప్లాస్మా మెమ్రిన్ is the total parts of the bacterial cells. Once again repeat, the bacterial cells are enveloped by three layers. Outermost layer glycocalyx, middle layer cell wall, innermost layer is the plasma membrane or cell membrane. The outermost layer glycocalyx is the outermost layer. It protect the cell wall, protect the cell wall. And these glycocalyx is again formation of two layers, capsule and slime layer. Capsule is the thick layer gelatinous sheath and it is made up of polysaccharides and important for MCET students polysaccharides and D-glutamic acid capsule is made up of polysaccharides and D-glutamic acids some bacteria produce capsules some bacteria do not formation of any capsules the capsulated bacteria produce smooth colonies the capsulated bacteria produce smooth colonies become virulent virulent means harmful or poisonous virulent means harmful or poisonous it releases toxins in rats causing pneumonia disease so this type of virulent type is called the S type virulent type is called the S type bacteria and some bacteria not produce capsulated non capsulated bacteria is called produce rough colonies and become non virulent this type of bacteria is called the r type bacteria so s type is virulent r type is non virulent s type is capsulated bacteria it means formation of capsule r type is non capsulated bacteria do not formation of capsule and next one is the slime layer is the very thin layer it is also protect the cell wall the slime layer also again made up of polysaccharides like a polysaccharides like a dextrin or dextran slime layer also made up of polysaccharides like a dextrin or dextran and next one is the middle layer or external to the plasma membrane below the capsule is called the cell wall in bacterial cells have rigid cell wall that's why they can easily survive in all atmospheric conditions so the bacterial cell wall is made up of peptidoglycan and murine very important for MCET students and other exams so bacterial cell wall is made up of peptidoglycan and murine in the bacterial cell wall contain element is the magnesium very important bacterial cell wall element is the magnesium it combined with the tycoic acid on the presence of tycoic acid on the cell wall or absence of tycoic acid the bacterial cells is again classified into two subtypes gram positive bacteria and gram negative bacteria this bacteria staining gram staining technique is discussed in another video and next one and middle and innermost layer below the plasma membrane or innermost layer is called the cell wall or plasma membrane this cell wall cell membrane or plasma membrane this plasma membrane act as a semi permeable membrane plasma membrane act as a semi permeable membrane why it is called semi permeable membrane it allow only some liquid like structures through the pores in this membrane have a small pores in this pores they allow only liquid like substances only through the pores that's why they are called selectively or semi permeable membrane these plasma membrane protect the internal organs also and next one here having liquid like structure in the internal part have liquid like structures is called the cytoplasm is called cytoplasm in this cytoplasm presence of 80% of water some enzymes ribosomes and carbohydrates some inorganic substances and next organelle is the ribosomes next organelle is the ribosomes these ribosomes are very minute smaller organelles and without membrane so it is freely in the cytoplasm without membrane that's why they are freely in the cytoplasm and minute smaller organelle these ribosomes is the main sites of the protein synthesis ribosomes is the main sites of protein synthesis in bacterial cells as in eukaryotic cells also so both prokaryotic eukaryotic its common function is the protein synthesis in ribosomes prokaryotic cells presence of 70s type of ribosomes s means Swedberg units these 70s is classified into subunits 50s and 30s one larger unit one smaller unit larger unit is 50s smaller unit is 30 years. So ribosomes are very important. Ribosomes function and type of ribosomes is important for MCET students. And next, another important organelle is the genophore. In bacteria, have two types of genetic material. One of the main genetic material and extra genetic material. The main genetic material or bacterial chromosomes is called the genophore. Or bacterial chromosomes are nucleoid. Nucleoid means in prokaryote having naked genetic material without any membrane. That is called the nucleoid. Nucleoid is only present in the prokaryotic organisms. It is important. And genophore is the main chromosomal genetic material or bacterial chromosomes. And it have another genetic material. Extra or additional genetic material is called the plasmid. Extra or additional genetic material is called plasmid. The term plasmid was coined by Lederberg. The term plasmid was coined by Lederberg in 1952. Plasmid appear like a, see once this plasmid circular double stranded. It is resistant to drugs and antibiotics. It is individually self-replicating capable. And next important organelle is the here have hair-like structures is called the pili. Here have small hair-like structures is called the pili. The pili is made up of a special protein is called the pilin, important for MCET students. What is the use of pili? It is used for during conjugation. It is used for during conjugation formation of conjugation tubes. So the through the conjugation tubes transfer of genetic material. That time pili is used for the formation of conjugation tubes. These pili are arranged from the cell wall, inner wall of the, middle wall of the cell wall. And here another organelle, here having long thread-like structures is called the plagellum. Plagellum is used for the locomotion. Plagellum is used for locomotion. It means movement of a bacterial cell in unfavorable conditions. In this plagella have a hook part, basal body and filament. These bacillus subtypes are already discussed in previous video. These are the total parts of the bacterial cell structure. Here I have another important structure is the mesosomes. Mesosomes are arise from the origin from the infoldings of the plasma membrane. Infoldings of the plasma membrane. These mesosomes are used for the during cell division formation of a cross wall, and it is used for the cell respiration and DNA replication. Mesosomes are important for the MCET students. Mesosomes are involved in cross wall formation in cell division and self replication and DNA self replicating. Here these are the total parts of the bacterial cell structure. Here have a very important question for MCET students and other competitive exams and IPE students. Inter second year students here having bacterial cell structure is the 4 marks question. Bacterial cell structure is the 4 marks question. And here genophore is the 2 marks question. What is genophore is 2 marks question. And plasmid is the 2 marks question. Total 8 marks questions in this topic in inter second year students. Bacterial cell structure 4 marks question. And 2 marks question. What is genophore? Genophore is the main bacterial chromosomal genetic material. And what is plasmid and explain their characters. Plasmid is the extra chromosomal genetic material and it is a self-replicating and resistance to drugs and antibiotics, circular and double standard. Enough. So total 8 marks for second year students. This topic is 10 marks question for degree first semester students. SI question. Bacterial cell structure and their functions and with diagram is a 10 marks question for degree first year student. Very important for the first semester students. In this topic, MCET bits is the bacterial cell wall is made up of peptidoglycan, murine. Another bit is the bacterial main genetic material is genophore. And bacterial extra chromosomal genetic material is plasmid. And the pili is made up of which type of protein is pilin. And another important bit, what is the function of the ribosomes? Ribosomes is the function is the protein
synthesis. And in prokaryote ku which type of ribosomes are present? 70s type of ribosomes are present in prokaryotic organism. Another one bit, which organelle is both common in prokaryotic and eukaryotics? Answer is the ribosomes. Ribosome is both common in prokaryotic and eukaryotic. So answer is ribosomes. So in cell wall, cell division, which organelle are participate in the cell division? Mesosomes are important for MCET students. S type which type of bacteria produce virulent phases? S type. Non-capsulated, R type. So in which type of organism presence of nucleoid? Example of answer is prokaryotic organism presence of nucleoid. So this topic is important for competitive exams and MCET students and IPA students. So in this video completed the bacterial cell structure, and next video we will discuss the another topic, bacterial reproduction. And if you like this video, please comment in the comment section. If you like this video, subscribe and comment in the comment section. Thank you for watching this video.